Welcome back. Through my preceding videos, we started to help you understand the basic definition of what Six Sigma is. We started with the thought that the Six Sigma could be understood in fourfold ways. Six Sigma as a problem-solving methodology, Six Sigma as a common yardstick of measurement of business processes, Six Sigma as a philosophy, and Six Sigma as a management system. I hope you've heard through our video on Six Sigma as a problem-solving method. Let's get to the next item. Six Sigma as a common yardstick of measurement of business processes. Oftentimes, in organization, when we seek to measure the performance of business processes, we have several matrices that come to our notice. We may be looking at revenue numbers, which is in pounds or dollars. We may be looking at hiring TAT, which could be in days. We could be looking at parts per million, which would be in count. CSAT, which is in percentage. And when you seek to compare on which business process is doing better, we are pretty much helpless. You cannot end up comparing days to dollars, to count, to percentage, etc., etc. Six Sigma has been able to come to our rescue in this. The process capability indices used in Six Sigma of DPMO or Z-scores could be used as a common yardstick of measurement of business processes. So if I'm looking at the hiring TAT, and if I have some target around it, I can decide what is the current performance of my TAT in terms of my Z-score or my DPMO or PPM value. Similarly, I could use, I could convert my revenue to a PPM or a Z-score, PPM to PPM, CSAT to PPM. So all my numbers would now either be in a Z-score or be in a PPM score. Then they are comparable. This makes decision-making much simpler, comparisons much simpler. This is yet another very, very critical usage of Six Sigma. Usage of Six Sigma as a common yardstick of measurement of business processes. I hope this simple video helps you get a perspective of the same. Thank you.